with a sentence to say, but they have a long, they have an interview with their words, like let's say P and B.
That sounds like a very big handicap.
What about the Kikuyu?
R and N.
R and
Rara. Can you pronounce it the way it should be pronounced?
Lala.
Yeah, and the Kikuyu say.
But I'm not a Kikuyu.
Yeah.
Hmm? I'm not a Kikuyu. Good.
So is there anything else you'd like to tell us about yourself? Some hobbies? What you enjoy doing for fun?
Okay, I love dancing. That's one of my talents. I'm a very good actor. I perform drama in school and music. That's what I do in school. I also participated in the music festival, and at least we went to the nationals. But unfortunately, there were some problems and didn't go.
Asante sana. Ni wewe kama mama. Asheta wewe. You know her father is a Maasai. Ashe Olen ni sema asante sana. Ashe Olen. And also when I want to say hello, I say soba. Ama dagwanya. Then she has me higo.
Tell us a little bit about you know, something that we don't know about you. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm very talkative, especially when I'm speaking to my friends. Mm. I know how to make fun of someone. And that's all.
Now you've seen your uncle and aunt, right? You see them together. What have you learned from them as far as couples?
What I've seen about them is that they're being patient. Then these let's say they've quarreled for this day. The next minute they're together, and that's loving each other. It's for the 8 years they've been together. That's all.
Have you learned anything for yourself as far as?
Around you, okay, and respecting everybody, no matter how, what's their level, whatever the level they are in, we are.
Well, your definition of relationships, huh?
Yeah.
Tell us what you understand a relationship to be.
Okay, what I understand about relationships is about loving each other, respecting each other, being obedient, and okay, love, no matter what someone does to you, it's all of you, then you kind of respect the person, understanding the person's situation. Yes.
Now, have they showed you anything that you learned about what it takes or quality that you learned to admire or something just by watching them?
Yeah, I've learned. I really learned, okay, loving. You know, that's the main thing about relationships. Loving each other, understanding each other. And then okay. What else is being patient? Not always quarreling. You know, like, let's say in a family where people are, someone is drunk. In that family, maybe they will be loved, but they'll always be quarreling. And what you teach the children is that quarreling is the only option for everything. So I've learned.
So give us an example of what you've seen and you've learned, that you've said to yourself, you know, that's something I'm going to keep in mind. Give us an example.
An example is that there's a thing that they can, how they speak to each other. You really kind of listen. Sometimes you just tell yourself, this is how it is. So you really tell yourself that, well, maybe let's attempt the exam, let's reach each week. I knew that maybe my relationship will be the best, okay, because of how you see them behaving, how they treat each other.
So now, you usually see women are the ones serving men, right? Is that what you see in this relationship? And speak up.
Okay, they shared. Let's say like the time when my aunt was not, they were sharing. Because let's say there's a time that she might be helping, or he might be helping. You can find him washing the utensils sometimes. I remember when I was with him, I used to wash them. It's kind of helping each other in everything that you do. Not only leaving to the women to do all the things.
So would you say the definition of what a lot of culture might teach people has changed from watching men?
Yeah, exactly.
So what is give us an idea of the traditional and what you see differently.
Okay, what I see different about them is that, about the tradition and the other culture, is that you really help each other. Because you're married to each other, you help each other in every situation. Even if she's not ill, she should help with things, mainly the chores are within the house.
So now, how does that change your perspective? How does that change the way you see things?
It is all about helping each other in everything that you do, not leaving one thing to the other or leaving the other to the other person. It's all about, if you can do it, because it's not a matter of options, it's a matter of if you know how to do it, don't leave it to the other.
Say for example, something that you assumed only men are supposed to do this, no I mean women are only supposed to do this,
yeah.
And you saw that your uncle was doing it. Give us one example.
One of most of all is washing utensils, cooking, and sometimes you can find him doing some things in the kitchen that a man cannot do it.
Such as?
Let's say wiping the table, those are such kind of things.
Now why do you think he does that?
Because of this one being love and helpfulness.
So do you say, if you are looking for somebody when you grow up, so you get older. you're how old again?
14.
When you get older, are you going to look for somebody who has no problem working in the kitchen and doing something or helping out?
It all depends. The other God is good.
But you learn something from all of this. Now, do you think if you think anything would have changed? Do you think he changed and did that, or was he always like that? Was he adjusting to anything, or?
Okay, when she got sick, that's when he started even being more. But before, he was doing that with some less than that. But then she got sick, he doesn't.
But do you hear him complaining when he's in the kitchen with the dishes? He doesn't complain. He doesn't. He doesn't say a comment. This is not for men. I'm not supposed to be doing this. No. What is his attitude?
He does it wholeheartedly, not minding if it's woman or man.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything else you guys would like to add?
Forget my son in Rose in the US. Working hard in hand with my daughters, they did a lot of work of caring after me, taking care, taking me to the hospital, and all this kind of thing, and using their finances. So I want to thank them very much and pray that God will help them and pay them.
Now tell us the story. How did you meet? Tell us the story of how you met.
We were all working in town.